We were trying to understand what happens when an animal is faced with a life-threatening event. And so basically, we know that in those circumstances, your whole body changes in a split second. You have changes in your brain state because you become highly alert. You have changes in your physiology, like your heart either pounds or actually stops for a brief moment. You have stress hormones, you become tense, like there's this whole host of changes. And these have been characterized extensively for a long time, for decades. People have been studying these responses to threat, but that doesn't mean that we understand them. And there's still a lot of things that we actually don't understand that we take for granted as if we understand. We know that, for example, if you face a threat and you try to escape, that your heart accelerates. We know that if you face a threat and instead you freeze because there's no escape, so you freeze to avoid being detected, your heart tends to slow down. So these are physiological responses that have been quite well characterized. Still, we don't really understand them. And so, for example, the fact that the heart decelerates, slows down, when we freeze, it's very unclear why that would happen. Why would you slow down your heart when you're freezing? We don't know. We don't know the answer to that question. And we were interested in the organization of defensive responses in animals at large. And Natalia Barrios, a postdoctoral researcher in my lab, studies this problem using fruit flies. Fruit flies are very amenable to studies of neuronal mechanisms, which is what we were mostly interested in. So we can study their neurons, we can turn them on and off, we can map their connections. There's a whole host of tools that one can use using fruit flies. What we've done was to put a fluorescent protein in the cells of the hearts of flies that we could image through the cuticle, which is the skeleton of the fly, okay? So we can image the heart from outside of the fly in an intact fly using a microscope. If you imagine a fly, it has an abdomen, and it has a thorax and a head. And these are almost like sealed compartments. And so the idea is that you have to push nutrients and cells from one place to another. And so basically these hearts contract, but they beat in different directions. You're either pumping things towards the thorax and the head, or you're pumping things back to the abdomen. And the heart keeps alternating between these two modes. And so this is another thing that we could look at. Is the reversal of direction changing with a threat? And if so, how? And is it related? Is it in the same direction that the change is in the beating frequency or not? So these were the questions that we were trying to address. And basically what we found was that just like invertebrates, what we saw was that if the fly responds with an escape to a threatening stimulus, in this case, our threatening stimulus was an expanding shadow. So it's as if an object is coming on a collision course. And so if the fly responds with running, what you see is that the heart accelerates. And when I say it accelerates, it both beats faster and it also starts alternating direction faster. And if the fly was freezing, we would see the opposite. We would see that the heart beats more slowly and it also reverses less frequently. And that was surprising. And the reason why that was surprising was because actually the way people thought about these changes in cardiac activity in mammals was that this was something that had emerged with the evolution of the autonomic nervous system. This autonomic nervous system is responsible for things like modulating cardiac activity, modulating the activity of our intestines and the stomach, and all sorts of physiological changes. It was believed that these changes in the heart appear once you have an autonomic nervous system, which the invertebrates don't have. And so for us, it was surprising to see that it has similar changes, which means that probably these regulation of cardiac activity happens before the emergence of an autonomic nervous system. And this would mean that maybe different animals find different solutions for the same problem. So the fly is doing the same thing. The end result is the same, is either making the heart go faster or slower, but using a different mechanism. Now the question really is it a different mechanism using the same principles? Do they have something that is not the autonomic nervous system, but is similar to it? And so this is something that we're very excited about now.